Welcome to this tutorial where we will be discussing a comprehensive method for determining the crystal structure and lattice parameters directly from X-ray diffraction, in short XRD data. The accurate identification of crystal structure and lattice parameters is essential in many scientific fields, including material science, chemistry, and physics. So let's dive in. XRD is a widely used technique for determining the structure of crystalline materials. And in this tutorial, we will explore a step-by-step approach to extract useful information from XRD data, identify the crystal structure, and extract the lattice parameters. The present tutorial will commence by exploring the Bragg's law of diffraction and its connection with the Miller indices, which in turn are linked to the crystal structure and lattice parameters. The scope of this tutorial is restricted to the cubic crystal system and its various subtypes. Following that, we will examine two practical examples, which will refer to as example 1 and example 2. In example 1, we will investigate several reflections at 2 theta and apply them to determine the crystal structure and lattice parameters. In contrast, in example 2, we will apply an XRD plot and conduct analogous calculations. Introduction. XRD data can be utilized to directly ascertain the crystal structure and its lattice parameters. However, obtaining precise results is a challenging task due to various factors, such as strain and microstrain that can cause peak broadening and affect certain calculations, including the determination of crystallite size. Therefore, it is recommended to employ Rightwell refinement or indexing methods to achieve accurate determination of the lattice and its parameters. Bragg's law establishes a correlation between the diffraction angle and the separation distance between crystal atomic planes. This correlation can be expressed mathematically as n lambda equal to d hkl sine theta, where n denotes the diffraction peak order, which is typically considered to be first order, that is n equal to 1. Lambda represents the wavelength of the X-ray used in the experiment, which is usually copper K alpha 1 equal to 1.5406 angstrom. DHKL is the interplanar spacing, and theta denotes the diffraction angle, which can be obtained from the XRD plot. We can rewrite equation 1 as DHKL equals lambda by 2 sine theta. Lattice parameters for a cubic structure. It is understood that the spacing between the planes in a crystal lattice, also known as interplanar spacing, is directly linked to the lattice constants and Miller indices. This relationship can be expressed mathematically as 1 over d square is equal to h square by a square plus k square by b square plus l square by c square. For the cubic system, where a is equal to b equal to c, the equation can be rearranged to give the formula for DHKL as DHKL equals a divided by square root of h square plus k square plus l square. Now comparing the DHKL from equation 2 and 3, defining S equal to h square plus k square plus l square and squaring both sides yields sine square theta over S equal to lambda square over 4a square. As S is required to be a whole number, that is integer, it assumes a fixed value for a particular pattern. There exists a set of integers for which sine square theta over S yields almost a constant value. Each crystal structure has a fixed number of possible reflections. Such a set of integers that are permissible for S, that is, the allowed reflections, are determined by taking into account the atomic scattering factors and structure factors that correspond to various crystal lattice types. For simple cubic, Reflections with any HKL are allowed. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. For body center cubic, only those reflections are allowed for which the sum of Miller indices is an even number. For example, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and so on. While for the face-centered cubic, the possible reflections are when H plus K plus L results in all odd or all even, that is 3, 4, 8, 11, 12, 16, and so on. The diamond cubic is an extension of the FCC, which has possible reflections when all the indices are even. In addition, H plus K plus L is a multiple of 4, that is 3, 8, 11, 16, and so on. In this section, we will discuss the role of theta values in our measurements. As we use sin theta instead of theta in lattice parameter, so the error will further minimize at higher values of theta. The error in sin theta approaches almost zero as the angle goes closer to 90. Thus, for the determination of the lattice constants, we will prefer higher angle values. Now in this section, we will consider a couple of examples to practically work out the crystal structure from an XRD plot. In example 1, let's say we are having this XRD pattern, for which we will determine the crystal structure and the lattice constants. First, we label the peaks in origin. How to do this, you may watch the video as shown in the above video info card regarding the use of a peak annotator tool. As we have found the peak's positions, now go to the Excel template in which we will do the calculations as discussed earlier in this tutorial. Please note that a link to this Excel calculation template will be provided for download in the video description. Here, this is the X-ray wavelength, and here we will put the two theta values as we found here. Next, we calculate the values of theta and sin theta. Then we move here, and now we will put different sets of integers and will check which of the set is giving the constant value for sin square theta or s. Let's first try the set of integers for the simple cubic structure. Thus the values of sin square theta comes out as this, which are equal to this column, in which for simple comparison, we have rounded them off. It is evident that these set of integers have no constant ratios, so the set structure is not a simple cubic structure. Now we try with another set of integers, that is the BCC structure. And now here we see that the ratio is constant, hence we conclude that the structure is a BCC structure. Once the structure is confirmed, we can now label the peaks with the Miller indices. To get 2 here, the possibility for HKL is 1, 1, 0. Similarly, 2, 0, 0. 2, 1, 1. 2, 2, 0. 3, 1, 0. Let's calculate the lattice constants. Here for average, we prefer the large angle values. So the average lattice constant comes out to be 3.56 angstrom. The standard value is 4.026 angstrom, so the percent error is 12%. In example 2, we have been provided with the peak positions and asked to determine the crystal structure and find the lattice constant. In the template, we repeat the same practice. First, we put the peak positions. And then test the set of integers. This column clearly shows that it is a simple cubic structure. We can now determine the Miller indices. Here the latest constant comes out to be 2.2421 angstrom. As we don't know the actual value, so the afterword columns are irrelevant. It is my sincere expectation that this tutorial has provided you with the necessary guidance to accurately ascertain the crystal structure, Miller indices and lattice constant from XRD data. Once the structure has been determined, the bond angles can be readily deduced.